Everything it seems, this world and its dreams slipping, watered through my head again. All the things I thought would fill me up, and so I left me empty. And now I know.
Folks that aren't in church, maybe they're your neighbors, they live down the street from you, maybe they're relatives. A lot of people come to church on Easter when they won't come any other time. So now is the time to begin to invite them. So make a point, maybe you're going to say, hey, I want to invite 2 people, I want to invite 5 people, 10 people. Invite as many as you want. We'll be glad to have them. We're going to have a great Easter service here at Summit Church. And look around and see those that you know are far from God. Some don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ. And that's the greatest need in your life. The best thing you can do is invite them. They can say yes, they can say no, but at least you would have invited them. Also, if you ever wonder how to pray for our church, we still have these little yellow slips back there. It talks about 5 things that we want to be praying for our church. And if you're not doing this on a consistent basis, we've got it back there at the information table. We'd be glad for you to pick that up. Also, remember, we are doing the bottles for the Pregnancy Resource Center. Put your loose change in it. We're going to bring them all back on Mother's Day. We're going to cut a check to the Pregnancy Resource Center. They do a wonderful, wonderful job. People find themselves in desperate situations, and they help people choose life for their babies, and that's a wonderful, wonderful ministry. So make note of that. All right. We're here today to worship. We're here today to hear from God. God spoke through prophets years and years ago. They wrote the words down, the words that God wanted to communicate to us. Those words live today in what we call the Bible. We believe that the Bible is the inspired word of God, that God speaks to us through His Holy Spirit. the same Spirit that inspired the writers of Scriptures, the Spirit that is at work in this world today, the Spirit that is at work in the lives of believers. And we just want God to speak to us today, to do a wonderful work in our lives. And we would be different because we've been here today. And I hope that's your prayer. I hope you've come with that expectancy, that you haven't just come hoping that something will happen, but that your heart is prepared, that you're expecting to hear from God, that you're expecting God to challenge you, to comfort you, that you're just expecting something to happen in your life today, okay? If you're not there, we're going to give you an opportunity to be there. And we're just going to have a word of prayer and ask God's blessing upon our time. And just if you're a visitor, let me just say this also. You got a card there. If you want to fill that card out at the end of our service, we're having an offering. You can put that card in there. Also, if there's a decision you need to make, if you want someone to pray with you, we'd be glad to pray with you also. You can indicate that in the card as well. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this day, and what a wonderful reminder that, Lord, every good and perfect gift comes from you. Lord, we look at a day like this, and it's a beautiful day. Sun's shining. Lord, it feels great outside. Lord, thank you for your creation. Thank you that you allow us to be a part of your creation. Lord, you just didn't create us and leave us. Lord, but you've created us and you've got a plan and a purpose for our life. And that purpose and that plan starts with forgiveness. That forgiveness is received as a free gift because of what your Son, Jesus Christ, did on the cross on our behalf. Lord, we just thank you for that gift of salvation. And thank you, Lord, it does not stop there. That you continue to work in our lives. You continue to move in our lives. And Lord, you've got a purpose and a plan for everybody here. And God, there's somebody here today that's dissatisfied. There's a lot of discontentment in their life. And yet they're a follower of Christ. I pray that they would be challenged and comforted and their lives would be changed because of their presence here today. Lord, as Philip and the band lead us in worship, I pray that our hearts would just sing out. God, that we would agree with the words that we're singing. And Lord, that there would be an expression of our heart towards you today. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
You stand with us as we give thanks to God.
Joyful, joyful, we adore you, God. Glory, Lord, love. Hearts unfold like life before you. Open to the sun.
Thank you.
fountain of the joy of living, ocean depths of happy rest. You are the one. Take all my sins.
Higher, higher, higher.
God, we thank you for your salvation. God, we thank you that because of your great love that you came for us, a sinful people, that you would have had every right to destroy every single one of us. But God, because of your great love, because of your infinite mercy and grace, we have hope and we have a future with you. So God, we praise you for that this morning.
Thank you for the way. Right.